people, just a couple of lines to give the feeling of the book. It's this doctor speaking, telling exactly about a situation where he checks people, and it starts with, I read it in Hebrew, but it's the sense that it's a sentence that starts with, it's less humiliating to be naked than to stay with your trousers down. פחות משפיל להיות בעירום מלא מלהישאר במכנסיים ותחתונים מפשרים עד הקרסוליים. פחות חסר אונים, שתי רגליים וגרביים ונעליים עסוקות זו לזו בקרסוליים עם מכנסיים ותחתונים כמו אסיר כבול בשלשלאות. מי שהמכנסיים שלו מופשרים עד קרסוליו לא יכול לברוח, אתה יכול לבצע בו בדיקה פנימית, אתה גם יכול באותה מידה להכניס לו אגרוף בפרצוף. או לראות על התקרה באקדח מחסנית שלמה. נמאס לי כבר להקשיב לכל השקרים האלה, לכל הרוחות, אני סופר עד שלוש, אחת, שתיים, תנסה להרפות, אני אומר שוב, תסתובב בזהירות היצר. אני אעצור כאן. כי זה הולך ומחמיר. I stopped before the tough part. It feels like you have a lot of inside information there. You write first person, you completely give yourself as a writer to the voice of this doctor. And I have two questions about it. One is about research, if you have to research and meet with people. And the other is about the identification twist in the book, and I'll ask you about it later.
Yeah, well, no, actually I didn't do any research. I was just using all the experience I personally had, or through family, or through friends, or people who told me anecdotes or bad stories about experiences in hospitals. And I think I've only been used for this kind of thing, and the rest must be imagination. And there is a moment when the doctor operates in his own eye. And that's the only thing I got comments from doctors who were saying that's not the way we do it. And I said, I know, because this is my own obsession and my fantasy. I'm wearing glasses because I could never think of putting something in my eye. And so I made, and I also have a good friend, a woman friend, who has the same kind of fear about putting things in her eye. I said, I will write this chapter for her. And she had to stop five times. And but this was a fantasy, but the rest it's just imagining. And actually there was a medical magazine who interviewed me in Holland and saying, how did you know these things about that these doctors are only there to stop the whole avalanche or tsunami of patients going to hospitals? Because that's official policy in medical school. I said, I didn't know that. I invented that.
Okay. Yeah, to put it mildly, he's not a nice person, Mark Schulze. He is cheating, he is doing and challenging every ethics of the doctor. He is violent, he is not faithful to his patients, to his wife. And while I was reading it, I thought to myself, while you were writing him, you were in first person, do you have to like a character in order to write it, at least a little bit?
Mm-hmm. No, the thing is, I don't plan this too much. So what happens really is that in the first pages, I got the voice of the doctor, and I knew, like in the first chapter, I'm